everyone, welcome to Simple Yoga. My name is Norma and I'm with the Positive Choice Integrated Wellness Center. Thank you all for joining. Hope your day has gone off to a good start already. We're gonna just breathe comfortably. We're going to relax. We're going to get your body up in a good positioning, good posture. Be mindful of anything that doesn't feel good to you, any posture, any pose that maybe is uncomfortable. You don't need to do it, just relax and wait for the other one. Also, please be very careful if your doctor has limited you on your exercise, be careful. This is a gentle yoga, so it should be okay, but always listen to your doctor first and consult with them to see if exercise is good for you. So let's go ahead and get started. Just relaxing through the shoulders, watching that your knees are over the center of your feet, toes are forward. And let's close our eyes, bring our palms up with thumb and index finger connecting. And just for a moment, take a comfortable inhalation. Slowly release that air. Another deep breath in through the nose. Slowly exhale out through the nose. Another full breath in. A gentle pause at the top and then slowly exhale. Side to side, making sure that you're getting a nice even stretch let's go in small little circles. Just gentle movement in that shoulder joint, that ball socket area. And gently go the other direction. Breathing in, breathing out, relaxing across the forehead, relaxing the muscles in the face, along the jaw, and turn the outer corners of your lips upward for that internal smile. Go in the other direction on those arms. Comfortable breathing. And then let's go ahead and just shake out those hands. Bring them forward, reach out in front. Let's take the right arm underneath the left, bend it, double bend the right. Arms are up, fingertips up, and you're going to open up along the upper back, across those shoulder blades, separate them. Breathe in, breathe out, lifting through the top of your head. Slowly release the arms, bring them down to your side, come back up in the center, take the opposite arm underneath, the left arm, double bend the right arm, palms towards each other, and just do the best you can with this pose. Open up across the shoulder blades, elbows, up shoulder height, and to the center of the room. Gentle breathing. Relax through the shoulders and across the back. Slowly release the arms all the way up, bring them down. And let's come forward on our chair. Let's take the right leg, cross it over the left. It's an active foot, so keep your toes up like if they were heading towards the shin. And then let's bring our arms back out. So now we're going to more to that Garudasana pose. You're going to take your right arm underneath, bend the opposite, breathing comfortably, lifting nice and high through the top of your head, lengthening your spine. Gentle breathing. And of course, if the palms don't come together, it's okay to keep that V. Or just do what's comfortable for you. Slowly release the arms, undo the leg, and switch to the other side. Bring the toes up towards the shin. The spine is nice and tall, and extend your arms out in front. Left arm underneath the right, and bend. Nose is forward, crown of the head is lifted. Center. Lengthen the abdominal wall as well as the spine. Feel that breath as you breathe in. Feel it settle into that upper back. And slowly release the arms and undo the leg. Inhale with the arms. On the exhale, swan dive down towards your ankles. Hold steady, stretch through the back. Swing the arms up, inhale, come all the way up, palms forward in Hastasana arms. Lengthen the abdominal wall, lengthen the rib cage, the spine. Take the hands behind your head, very gently open up those elbows out to the sides, expand across the chest. And then release those arms out, take the arms back as far as you can, bringing the shoulder blades towards each other. Inhale, bring the arms back up to Hastasana, and exhale, bring them down to Cactus Pose. Open up across the chest, lengthen through your spine. Bring your arms back towards the center into lotus hands. Gentle breathing. palms up, shoulder height, out to the center of the room. And then slowly release those arms down. Again, inhale, come up. Exhale, swan dive down towards the ankles. Release the head and the neck if it's okay for you. And inhale up, swinging the arms all the way up into Hastasana arms. Lengthen the abdominal wall, the spine, the rib cage. Slowly bring the hands behind your head, lightly elbows out to the side. Breathing in, breathing out. And then take the arms out into cactus palms, opening up across the chest. Bring the arms to the center with lotus flower. And slowly bring the arms down. Shake it out. Let's sit to the center of the chair or a little further back. We're going to take the right arm. Inhale, coming up. Exhale, reach over the head. It's a very gentle side bend. Breathe in through the nose and out through the nose. Hold it steady. So think of holding your poses for 3 to 5 breaths. Don't be in a big hurry to come on out of it. Slowly come on up. Switch arms. Inhale up. Exhale, reach over your head gently. Try to get the bicep over your ear, line yourself up comfortably. Breathing in, breathing out. Slowly come on up and inhale both arms up. On the exhale, we're going to do a blowing palm. You're going to take that right wrist up and over your head. Hold it steady and breathe. It's a little more challenging because you don't have the other arm for support. So if it feels more challenging, not quite comfortable, just drop your left arm down onto the chair. Slowly come on up. Breath in, switch the way you reach for the wrist, and exhale, reach over your head. Try to keep the bicep over your ear, breathing in and breathing out. Relax through the shoulders. And slowly come on up and release the arms all. Take your shoulders, lift them up and around. Good breaths in through the nose and out through the nose. Take them as deep as you want. Make them comfortable for you. And then shake it out. Lean back onto your chair. So you're sitting all the way back. Use the back rest for your back. And go ahead and bend those elbows. And let's open and close. Fingers, I mean. Thumbs over the top. Open and close. Now remember, there's a lot we do with our hands throughout the day. So you want to make sure that we're making constant effort to move those hands, those fingers. Okay, a lot of tendons, ligaments, bones, muscles in those hands, into the digits. Then take the big thumb and bring it underneath. Just bring it underneath. Clasp those fingers over it. It's okay if you crack a few knuckles here and there. Just reach, but open up. All those fingers open up. Breathing in, breathing out. And then I want you to touch the little finger, ring finger, middle finger, index finger, and then repeat. Okay, so getting each fingertip, tapping it onto the thumb. You can take your time with it. You can go a little faster with it. whatever makes you feel comfortable. You can close your eyes and do it and see if it changes anything. Always taking away one of the senses is going to change things. Makes you work a little harder. Go ahead and open up your eyes when you're ready. And then go ahead and bend at that second knuckle. Just bend those fingers like they were hanging onto something. Just bend. And then open, bend. Open, bend. Open, bend. Nicely, nicely done. Good, good. There you go. Seems like such a trivial thing to do, but really it's so good for those hands and those fingers. And then bring them down and really shake it out, shake it out. Now what I want you to do is, we are into the fall weather, not that we feel it, but it is here, so I want you to take the heel of your hands and I want you to kind of dig it in to those quadricep muscles, to the inner thigh muscles and the outer thigh. Not only are you giving your body and your legs good circulation, getting that blood circulating well, you're warming up those limbs as well. And you get to work the upper body, the arms, the chest, the back. Because I want you to apply all that upper body weight onto the legs, into the heel of the hands, to the legs. So when you get cold, start patting. So look at my hands. I'm cupping them and I'm going to just start patting the quadricep, inner thigh, outer thigh. Patting it. Don't be afraid. Don't be shy. Just do it. Your legs can handle it. Now, don't do it too hard either, okay? There's a difference. So just be mindful of your body, good circulation, and then go around the knee gently. Very gently go around the knee. I'm not doing the patella. Don't do the kneecap. Just going around gently. I want to be real careful with my knees. And then let's go to the shins and the calves, outer calves, back of the calves. I'm going to slap them back there. And then I'm just going to cup and go to the front. You can slap the front tibialis, anterior tibialis, okay? And then we're going to come up and we're going to go super light, just very light around those legs, around the knees, and around the calves. Very, very gentle, feather gentle, very nice. Letting your body, letting your legs know we're about done. Thank you for letting us create the circulation, get that blood flowing in the legs. And then I want you to sweep off anything that doesn't belong in there. Any negative stuff, any hurtful stuff, just get it off you. Shake it off your hands. Good. And then let's sit back on the chair. Inhale up. Exhale. Just let that air out. Again, inhale up. Exhale. Let that air out. Good. And then just shake out those hands. Nicely done. Let's get down here on the toes and let's scoop onto the necks of the toes. Once you've done that and you can bring your foot back comfortably, I want you to slide your buttock forward. And this is a time where you're actually going to see the knees over your toes, which we always say don't do. But this is a very controlled move, so it's okay. So, knees are over the toes. We're putting a little pressure on the necks. We do have to stretch the bottoms of the feet. It's really important. But I want you to also take note of all the necks of the toes down. So as many toes as you have, the neck should be down. All right, little pressure on your thigh. Hinge forward. Just a little pressure on the necks of the toes. Keep the knees forward. Breathing in and breathing out. Doing good. I know this is really hard for some of you. I'm sorry. But it's really a good stretch. Or if you're at home, get a tennis ball and you can rub your foot along that tennis ball. Just roll with it. Side, inward, forward and back. Yeah, just the tennis ball is super good to do. And then let's release the feet. Now bring the heels up, bring the balls of the feet up. Now the heels. Balls of the feet, heels. Balls of the feet, heels. All right, so again, you might hear some little cracks, crackle sounds in those feet. That's okay. They really do need this. So, up with the heels, up with the balls of the feet. And then just tap one at a time. Tap, tap. You can remember, do these for that, again, anterior tibialis muscle in the front. And then both of them just tapping. Tap, tap, tap. Yes, tap, tap, tap. Good. And then take your right foot, wrap to the side, and just circle around that ankle. Be good to those feet. Go the other direction, just circle. Go as slow, go as whatever pace is comfortable for you. Okay, let's try the other foot. Take it around, just circle. And then go the other direction. Circle it. There you go. Does that feel good? Maybe, maybe not. It's different with everybody. All right, and now let's take our left foot and bring it up. So this is our modified pigeon pose, but we're going to lead into something else. So just hold it steady there. So this one stretches in the buttock, the outer thigh, your IT band. And make an active yoga foot. So that means bringing those toes towards your shin, this direction here. Stretch the bottom of your foot. Hands are at your heart center. Take a breath in. As you exhale, hinge forward very gently. Feel that beautiful stretch deep in the backside. Just take it only where it feels good for you. Three to five calming breaths. slowly come on up, and we're going to thread the needle. So exhale, come down inside of those legs, reach for the outer calf, inner calf. Again, it's a little deeper stretch in the backside. And then slowly come up. Now, we're going to keep the foot there, but we're going to turn, we're going to just kind of let the ankle go down a little bit, and we're going to turn the foot towards us. I want you to take your hands, take the ball of the foot in your hands, and I want you to center the ball of the foot. So pick up that little toe side. You're kind of twisting it just a little bit comfortably, okay? So that now the foot is completely facing diagonal out to the side. Take your big toe, pull it back, and forward. Again, the other toe, forward and back. And the other toe, forward and back. The little toe, forward and back. Okay? Take the heels of your hands, and I want you to knee into the ball of your foot. Knee into it like if it was bread dough. Just knee into it. Don't be shy. Okay? And after you do that a few times, take your knuckles and go up the center of your foot. Go up. Might tickle, might not. You can go horizontal or you can go vertical, but use those knuckles. Okay? Keep those toes down. It's a good massage on the foot. And then the heel, I want you to use your thumbs. And I want you to just press down and forward, press down and forward, down and forward. Go all the way up your foot, all the way to the ball of the foot, all the way up to the toe end. Squeeze, let go. Just gave yourself a foot massage. Okay, other leg. Let's go ahead and pull it up. Sit up nice and tall. This is modified pigeon pose. Good for those, again, buttock muscles, outer thigh. So toes are active towards your shin. Hands right at your heart center. Take a breath in. As you exhale, hinge forward gently. Three to five calming breaths. Thread the needle, breath in. Exhale, hinge forward. Reach for the inner thigh, or the inner calf, outer calf. Slowly come on up. And then we're going to take your foot, so slide it over just a little bit, and I want you to turn the ankle so that the ankle goes down just a little bit. And turn the ball of the foot towards you, okay? Use those thumbs, use the fingers, and I want you to really turn that foot. Don't be shy, it'll be fine, okay? So the ball of the foot, you can see all the undersides of your toes, and then I want you to start kneading with your thumbs into the ball of the foot. Breathe in, breathe out. Okay, it's a good solid foot, so take your time. Do what feels good to you. Some people's feet are a little more sensitive than others. It's okay. And then I want you to take that big toe, bring it forward, and then bring it back. Don't be shy, they're not going to fall off. Go forward with the other toe and bring it back. And forward with the other toe, bring it back. And then the other toe, bring it back up to the little toe and bring it back. And then bring those toes forward, pull those toes back. Okay, so then I just want you to start massaging again the ball of the foot into the necks of the toes. Use those thumbs. Okay, necks of the toes, ball of the foot. Now take the knuckles horizontally, go up and down through the center of the foot. Just your knuckles, just like this. Forward and back, forward and back. You can go vertically and just go right in the center of the foot and just go up and down, whichever way. Alternate it, up and down, and then horizontal. Then the heel, use your thumbs, dig in there, dig in the heel. Dig. And then take those thumbs and start going up the center of your foot, all the way to the ball of the foot, to the necks of the toes, and squeeze out through the tips of the toes. Done. Okay, and bring that leg down. Sit all the way back, relax those arms. So let's sit in seated mountain pose. Just relax the shoulders. Close your eyes for a moment. So you work those hands, those arms, the feet. So now just close your eyes and comfortably breathe in, breathe out. Relax through your shoulders, the crown of the head, front of the face, the forehead. Relax the back of the head as well. Down your spine, your shoulders, and down your arms, your legs, your hips, your hands, and your feet. Slowly open up your eyes, shake out those arms. We're going to turn to our side. So we're going to do a simple twist. So just sitting sideways up your chair, lift high through the top of your head, take a breath in. As you exhale, bring both arms around to the back of your chair, hold the sides of your chair, look back, and give yourself a nice twist. Relaxing those arms down at your side, just breathing comfortably. Slowly come on back to the center. And let's go to the other side. Sitting with your head up nice and high, relaxing through the shoulders. Take a deep breath in. As you exhale, come around to the back of the chair, hold with both hands, look back, just turn your head and look all the way back. For you, or bend the knee. Bring the arms out in front. Inhale, raise them up. Bring them down to cactus pose arms. To lotus flower. And all the way down. Let's help that back leg in. Okay, now again, sitting over to the side, we're going to take our left ankle, drop the knee down, hold on to the side of the chair, and stretch your quadricep muscle. I'm going to turn to the side so you can see. Reach, drop. I've got an active foot. Okay, I want to get that quadricep as stretched out as I possibly can. Slowly release the foot, and then let's go to the other side. Again, I'm going to stay to the front so I can show you. I'm holding onto the side of the chair. Grab your ankle, bring the knee towards the floor, look straight ahead. Active foot. Gentle breathing. Slowly release the leg and come back to center. Now, this next pose is good for the digestive system. It works well too if you have a chair in front of you or a bench in front of you, or you're going to sit back of your chair, bring the right foot up and the heel on the chair. Now, I know it's really close, so just you can put a chair in front of you. You're going to wrap around the knee, and you're going to slowly bring the forehead, the nose, or your lips, or just bring it to where it's comfortable for you. Shoulder blades are in towards each other, and that goes for even if you're sitting or laying down. Close your eyes and just allow yourselves to relax completely, letting go of any tightness in your shoulders, your back, maybe the back of your head. You relax through the shoulder blades, your spine. To the right side, helping yourself up. And if you're on the chair, just taking a few breaths in and a few breaths out. Thank you, everybody, for taking the time for yourselves and for sharing this time with all of us here together. I hope this made you feel a little more energized, more alive, or even just more relaxed and in tune to yourself. So I hope to meet with you next week and that everybody is doing their part to stay well, to stay safe. Remember those guidelines that we have. And I've got to share one with you for me is congregating with people who you're normally not with. That was something different for me. You know, you get invited to special occasions and this and that, but how many times have you been with those people? So just think about it. Keep the distance, wash your hands, wear your mask, be mindful of who you're with and what you're doing. And we'll get through this. We'll all be together again in the same room. Thank you, everybody. Have a wonderful day, wonderful week. Namaste.